Hey guys, I'm SPARTAN117GW, and today we're going back in time to World War II. So this is the standard paratrooper loadout for the 101st Airborne, specifically focused on the M1 carbine. Roz, can you tell us about your setup?
So I got the helmet, start off with the gear. I got 1936 suspenders. The paratrooper specifically had a very specific setup because they needed lighter weight stuff, but also being able to carry more gear and adapt easily to different conditions that they were in. So the 1936 suspenders have D-rings where they could attach their musette bag, which would hold all of their food, extra clothing, ammo, toiletries.
All their extra field equipment.
Extra field equipment, yes. And attached to that, I have my 1936 pistol belt, which would carry all of my ammo using either carbine pouches or rigger pouches. Rigger pouches are a little bit more interesting because they were specifically designed for airborne units, and they could hold either 4 8-round end block clips for the M1 Garand or 5 M1 carbine magazines. So those were specific to paratroopers, and of course we had our standard infantry gear, similar gear, which would be our canteen and our shovels. And of course our first aid kits that would go on our back. And yeah, that's it for the field gear, on me at least.
Well, tell us about the actual uniform itself. What's different than the standard infantry setup?
Different from the standard infantry setup is that we actually, paratroopers, at least in the early war, had our own uniforms specifically modified for paratroopers, similar to what you're wearing. Mine is configured specifically for the D-Day invasion, or Overlord, and Operation Overlord, I should say. And it had reinforcements along the pockets and on the knee pads and elbow pads. So, because early on in the war, they found out that knee and elbow areas would be torn very easily, and things inside of the pockets would blow out. So they needed more reinforcement and things like that. It's specific to this uniform.
Are there any specific modifications for the 101st?
101st Airborne was very well known for their uniform modifications, so such as on my back, I added rigger modified pockets so I could carry more things such as ammo, socks, gloves, if that came that was needed.
Tell us about the weapons platform.
The weapons platform is the M1 A1 carbine. This model was specific to paratroopers, and they needed something that would bridge the gap between a full-length rifle cartridge and a pistol cartridge, so they came up with a 30 carbine. Effective out to about 300 yards. This specific model, since it's the M1A1 carbine and paratrooper model, it has a folding stock, which allowed it to be easily stored away inside of a carrying case that paratroopers would carry along the side of their uniform when they initially jumped. So instead of taking several seconds to unpack a Garand from a Griswold bag, they would only have to spend half the amount of time pulling this out, and it would be fully loaded and assembled, and you'd be ready to go within just a few seconds. This is actually a King Arms Airsoft M1A1 carbine. It has the folding paratrooper stock, specific to paratroopers during World War II, and some paramarines. And this is a gas blowback operating. So, pretty neat, and it's good for airsofting.
And milsim.
And milsim, cool. Yes.
Well, thanks for telling us about your 101st Airborne Carbine Loadout.